Hi, my name is Martin Weicker and I'm the founder of the global MSL training company called From Science to Pharma. And I'm your host today and we'll be recording this from my studio here, my balcony, in a sunny winter in Sydney. Welcome to the first ever Medical Science Liaison channel episode where we will be answering all your questions about Medical Science Liaison, medical affairs, any developments in pharmaceutical industry and anything more. Before we start, make sure you subscribe here at the bottom to this channel so you will be kept up to date on any new developments. So let's get started with our first ever question. What is an MSL? Or what does an MSL do? It's probably the most common asked question and probably the simplest question, but probably also the hardest to answer. The MSL role is quite complex and it's a role within the pharmaceutical industry and biotech company. And the name already suggests what it does. You liaise between the company and external stakeholders on anything that's medical and scientific related. The objective of most MSLs is to support a best-in-class launch of a pipeline drug, make sure that there are little to no barriers to uptake of this drug once it comes on the market after the regulators have approved the drug. This is easier said than done, right? As every drug and every disease in every territory or every country comes with its own challenges. Based on your overall brand and medical plan, you will have your own in-field medical plan as a medical science liaison, where you will work and reach out to many of the different stakeholders that we often call KOLs or also called key opinion leaders. These key opinion leaders could be anyone between like clinicians, head of departments, head of pharmacies, nurses, professors, payers, insurance, you name it, can be anyone. Anyone that's important for your drug in that part of the product life cycle. Besides being involved in a lot of medical projects and educational projects, you also have a lot of peer-to-peer discussions with your KOLs, in which you often use clinical papers or conference abstracts. And in these meetings, you will try to create familiarity for your clinical data and develop advocacy for your drug by highlighting how your drug will address the unmet medical needs of the patient. During these conversations, you also try to uncover how your drug fits in the current treatment algorithm and how it can potentially change the disease management and patient management in the future. Are there any risks or challenges with the drug that you need to mitigate quickly in order to make sure that this drug will be a success once the drug is approved, so success for the patients and doctors and also the company? And all this information you will obtain in your clinical discussions or in your presentations with these KOLs, you will feed back to the internal stakeholders that will further drive the strategy internally. So this is the MSL role in short. It's actually quite a lot more complex than this, but let's get back into that in later episodes. So if you're interested to know more about how to transition into an MSL role without industry experience, just scroll down and join our free, there's actually a link, join our free webinar and sign up to that. If you just remember it, it's www.fromsciencetopharma.com/resources. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Give it a thumbs up or a 5-star rating. And if you'd like to translate this video in any of your own favorite languages, please do so and it would make my day. So thank you very much for our first MSL channel episode and look forward to see you in the future. See you.